welcome to my next video in the series about plasma membranes, and today we're going to be looking at answering more exam questions. So these questions are taken from the EdExcel biology course, and this is taken from the Unit 1 paper. And so the question is, the size and the solubility of molecules has an effect on their ability to be taken up by cells. So describe an experiment you've carried out to investigate the permeability of cell membranes. And so the key term here is describe. And so all you're going to do is list down a method that you've done to test the permeability, and the experiment hopefully that you've done is the beetroot experiment. And so this question is out of 5 marks, and so you need to be saying at least 5 things. And so the first thing that gets your mark is by mentioning the fact that you've used beetroot to do this. And so when you've hopefully done this practical, the first thing that you've done is wash the beetroot to remove excess pigment. From there, you probably have done one of two experiments, either changing the temperature or changing the level of ethanol. So if we're looking at temperature, you could use a water bath to control the temperature. So this could be using the 5 or 6 different temperatures you were looking at. Or if you did the ethanol experiment, it could simply be keeping it at a fixed temperature. You then need to mention at least 5 different temperatures, so 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, and then concentrations of ethanol exactly the same. You need to mention at least 5, usually done as a percentage. You then need to talk about your control variables, so this will be things like how long it's left in the solution, then the size of the beetroot, the condition of the beetroot that you've used, how it was stored. Basically all the things you do to keep it a fair test, and you probably need to list down at least 2 or 3. The dependent variable, you need to say what it is that you're measuring. So this will be using a piece of equipment like a calorimeter, and this measures things like absorbance, transmission, maybe intensity of coloration, but basically is where you state what the dependent variable will be. Mention the fact you use a calorimeter as a piece of equipment to determine the intensity of the colour of the liquid produced, gets you another mark, and the final mark is to do with repeats and reliability. So mention that you repeat each concentration or each temperature a number of times. And so it's any 5 from those possible 8. So the next question is, an investigation was carried out into the permeability of a cell membrane to a number of different non-polar organic molecules. The molecules differed in their size and their solubility in oil compared with their solubility in water. The higher the solubility, the more soluble the molecule is in oil compared with water. The graph below shows results in the investigation. The size of the circle drawn on the graph indicates the size of the molecule. The larger the circle, the larger the molecule. And so, the first question is, describe what relationship, if any, there is between the permeability of the cell membrane and the size of the molecules. So you essentially have 3 things on this graph. You have not only its solubility in oil compared with water, you also have its permeability, and you also have the size of the molecule. So in this first part, it's asking you the relationship between the permeability of the cell membrane and the size. So the membrane permeability is this one, and the size of the molecule is indicated by how big the circle is. And there's no pattern here. You have big ones down here, you have large ones here, small ones are dotted around in different locations. There seems to be no relationship, so no correlation. Part 2, describe what relationship, if any, there is between the permeability of the cell membrane and the solubility of the molecule in oil compared with the water. So this is asking for a comparison of the permeability and solubility. And so clearly, the more soluble it is in oil compared with water, the greater level of permeability there is. That's reasonably straightforward. Part 3 is a little bit more difficult. Water is able to diffuse across the cell membrane even though it's a polar molecule. On the graph, draw a circle labelled W to indicate the permeability of the cell membrane to water. The size of the circle should represent the size of the water molecule. Right. It says in the first sentence, water is able to diffuse through the cell membrane. That must mean it has a very high permeability. Therefore, it must be somewhere at the top portion of the graph. If it's high permeability, it must be near the top somewhere. If you then look at the solubility in oil compared with water, well, clearly, water is not very soluble in oil. So therefore, its solubility in oil compared with water must be quite low. So you draw the circle anywhere in the top left. So somewhere like that. Now, the important thing here, it says the size of the circle should represent the size of the water molecule. Now, This is slightly too large, the circle that I've drawn. It should be less than one square because water is a very, very small molecule and hence why it should be exceptionally small. And what they give the mark for on the test paper is it must be smaller than a single square. And the final question, use your knowledge of the structure and the properties of the cell membrane to explain the results of the investigation. So clearly, what it's showing is the higher level of solubility in oil compared with water, the higher level of permeability. So what you've got to do is you've got to think about what you know about the structure and the property of the cell membrane that explains this in the investigation. So the structure, you simply get a mark for describing the membrane as a phospholipid bilayer. That's a single mark for that. Now, property of that, the actual phospholipid is made of two parts, the phosphate head and the fatty acid tail. By mentioning the fact that the tails are hydrophobic and don't like water, you therefore gain an extra mark from there. Describing the results of the experiment, so saying the more soluble it is in oil compared with water means it has a greater permeability, gets you another mark. So essentially saying what the results have shown. And the final two marks, so the idea that the permeability is linked to the readiness to dissolve, and so that the higher the solubility, the more likely it is to dissolve in the phospholipid bilayer. And finally, if you reference to something of the fluidity of the movement of the phospholipids, that also gains a mark. But the top three are the easiest ones really to get. So mentioning the phospholipid bilayer, that's simply the structure. Reference to the hydrophobic nature, that reference to the properties, and then saying what happened in the practical. So saying the more soluble it is in oil, the more permeable it is. Simply we'll get the three marks there.